I now invite the distinguished delegate of India, Mr. Ajit Kumar Mohanty, Chairman of the Atomic Energy Commission and Secretary, Department of Atomic Energy, to take the floor.
Mr. President, Director General Grossi, Excellencies, Ladies and Gentlemen, Namaste, a very good morning to all of you. On behalf of the Government of India, I extend my warm greetings to the International Atomic Energy Agency and its member states. I feel privileged to represent India and deliver this national statement to this august audience. I convey my sympathy to our host, Austria, for the difficulty they faced due to an unprecedented flooding. I also welcome the newly admitted members of the agency. Happy to note that two countries, Nepal and Bahrain, have been admitted as members in Middle East and South Asia group, which would enable them to play a more active role within the agencies. Mr. President, please accept our heartiest congratulations on your election to the post of President of the 68th session of the General Conference of IAEA. I assure you of India's full support and cooperation for the agency in its efforts to promote peaceful uses of atomic energy. This year is the special to us as you are at 70 year of our existence as Department of Atomic Energy. It gives me great pleasure to show that we are able to harness the goodness of atomic energy for the benefit of society and environment in the true spirit of atoms in the service of mankind. I am proud to mention here that India continues to broaden its horizon through basic and directed research in the field of nuclear science and technology, both for power and non-power applications of atomic energy. It would be my privilege to share some of the highlights of our achievements since the last conference. Mr. President, Atomic Energy Regulatory Board continued to maintain regulatory oversight on the nuclear and radiation installation to ensure that activities are conducted in a safe and secured manner. Some of the notable regulatory clearances were permission for fast approach to criticality, low power physics experiments, phase C commissioning, and progressively raising the power of unit 4 of Kakrapar atomic power projects in the state of Gujarat, and core loading of control and safety rod, blanket, etc. in the prototype fast beta reactor. Towards capacity addition, Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited has started commercial operation of two units of indigenous 700 megawatt pressurized heavy water reactors at Kakrapar Atomic Power Station in last 1 year. Also, initial fuel loading is completed in another unit of 700 megawatt PHWR at Rajasthan Atomic Power Station. Closed fuel cycle, being the cornerstones of Indian nuclear power program, country's first prototype 500 megawatt fast beta reactor at Bhavini is undergoing core loading, paving the way for fast approach to criticality. Towards strengthening the fuel supply chain, a greenfield nuclear fuel complex at Kota, Rajasthan has now entered in advanced commissioning stage, which will mainly cater the requirement of the upcoming fleet of indigenously built PHWRs. As India sets its path to establish itself as a developed nation, Viksit Bharat, Government of India has envisaged a significantly greater role for nuclear energy in next 2 decades to ensure dual challenge of energy security and balancing climate goals. Towards that pursuit, our government has recently announced to partner with the private sector for setting up a Bharat Small Reactor, research and development of Bharat Small Modular Reactor, and newer technology for nuclear energy. Acknowledging the role of clean hydrogen in energy transition and the potential use of nuclear energy in production of clean hydrogen, Bhabha Atomic Research Center has forayed into pilot scale demonstration of copper chlorine thermochemical cycle of hydrogen production. A pilot scale integrated facility for nuclear hydrogen production has been installed and commissioned. Towards application of radiation technology in healthcare, food security and industry, Board of Radiation of Isotope Technology, together with IAEA, conducted an awareness session titled Atoms for Humanity, showcasing its advanced radiation technology and products in support of agency's flagship programs, Rays of Hope and Atoms for Food. I invite all the delegates to our exhibition in the sidelines of 68th GC, showing our radiation technology-based solution for societal applications. The National Cancer Grid, now a 310-member network across the country, spearheaded by Tata Memorial Center, treats approximately 60% of country's total cancer load, The international network of the program NCG Bishwam is making its mark in spearheading standard and cost-effective cancer care, making it accessible to vulnerable sections of society globally. For the first time in the country, Variable Energy Cyclone Center, collaboration with Board of Radiation and Radiation Isotope Technology, has done trial production of SPECT radioisotope LEAD-203 for imaging and cancer therapeutic applications using a low-cost natural thallium target using 30 MeV cycloton facility. Pilot-scale production of radioisotopes yttrium-90 and phosphor-32 has also commenced at Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research for Societal Applications. Heavy Water Board, the largest global producer of heavy water, continues exporting heavy water to several countries for non-power applications, including medical and healthcare. Mr. President, Global Center for Nuclear Energy Partnership has recently renewed Memorandum of Understanding with IAEA and continues to host various multilateral programs. India's presidency over G20 summit last year ended with reaffirmation of use of nuclear energy in the respective national energy mix by the G20 nations, and role of small modular reactors was particularly highlighted as supplementary to large reactors. In March 2024, India participated in the Nuclear Energy Summit at Brussels and reiterated its commitment to achieve net zero emissions target by 2070. At the dawn of the new era of nuclear energy, India stands ready to partner with agency and other like-minded member states to harness the potential nuclear energy through science and technology and contribute to a future defined by growth, innovation, and energy security. With that, I, on behalf of my beloved nation India, extend our sincere gratitude to the city of Vienna, the people, and the government of Austria for the hosting the General Conference of IAEA. India remains committed to the peaceful use of nuclear energy, both on the research and application fronts. We wish the 60th General Conference a grand success. Thank you, and Jai Hind.
I thank the distinguished representative of India for his statement.